In this video, we will solve 11 different types of numerical problems based on operational amplifier. Normally, an operational amplifier has different formulas for inverting, non-inverting, summing, subtractor, differentiator, integrator, which is confusing to remember. Here, we will solve all these types of operational amplifier with the help of Kirchhoff's node analysis without remembering any formula. First, let us know a brief information about operational amplifier. The operational amplifier has a total of 8 terminals, of which here we have displayed only 3 terminals. The terminal with the negative symbol is called inverting terminal because the applied voltage on this terminal is invert by 180 degree at output. The terminal with the positive symbol is called non-inverting terminal because the applied voltage on this terminal is found without invert at output. The third terminal is output terminal. One thing to be noted here is that input impedance of the operational amplifier is very high, so the current flows directly through the resistance RF given for the bypass rather than through its inverting terminal. This resistance is called feedback resistance. In the presence of this feedback resistance, this operational amplifier is called closed loop operational amplifier. Whatever voltage drop occurs at the non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier, it always appears at the node point A because of the virtual ground condition. An operational amplifier produces a kind of voltage gain in the input voltage, the value of which depends on the operational amplifier. In this video, we will not discuss about concept of virtual ground and Kirchhoff's current and voltage rule. Videos on these topics are already available on our channel. If you want to know more about them, link is in the description. Now let's talk about how to apply Kirchhoff's node analysis on the circuit of an operational amplifier. When a voltage is applied to the input, a current I1 flows from resistance R1, but due to high input impedance of the operational amplifier, it starts to flow from resistance RF at the node point A. In this case, the current entering at the node point A must be equal to the outgoing current, so I1 will be equal to I2. Talking about I1 current, it is flowing in R1 resistance. Then its value will be equal to the difference of the applied voltage at both terminal of the resistance and the ratio of the resistance R1. Similarly, current I2 is flowing in resistance RF, then its value will be equal to the difference of the applied voltage at both terminal of RF and the ratio of RF. Now let's solve numerical problems. Exercise number 1. Determine the output voltage. The input voltage in the given operational amplifier is applied to the inverting terminal, so it will be called an inverting operational amplifier. I1 current at the node point will be equal to the I2 current. Assuming the voltage at the node point A is VA, then the value of current I1 will be VI minus VA upon 100 kilo ohm, and the value of I2 will be VA minus V0 upon 500 kilo ohm. Since the value of VI is given 2 volt and the non-inverting terminal is grounded, the value of VA from virtual ground condition will be 0. Solving this brings the output voltage to minus 10 volt. In next exercise, input voltage is applied to non-inverting terminal instead of inverting terminal. Therefore, it will be called non-inverting operational amplifier. Again at node point A, I1 will be equal to I2. Value of I1 will be 0 minus V upon 100 kilo ohm, and value of I2 will be VA minus V0 upon 500 kilo ohm. We know that current will not flow through the non-inverting terminal. This can happen only if the resistance has the same potential on both terminals, meaning B terminal will also have a potential of 2 volt, and because of the virtual ground condition, this voltage will also appear on the node point A. So solving this, the output voltage comes to 12 volt. Exercise number 3. 3 input voltage has been applied instead of 1 input at the inverting terminal. Such an operational amplifier is called summing operational amplifier. Notice here, 3 current is entering at the node point A and 1 current is going out. So by node analysis, the sum of I1, I2 and I3 will be equal to I4. The value of I1 current will be minus 2 minus VA upon 200 kilo ohm. The value of I2 is 2 minus VA upon 250 kilo ohm. The value of I3 is minus 1 minus VA upon 500 kilo ohm, and the value of I4 will be VA minus V0 upon 10 kilo ohm. The potential at the node point A from virtual ground condition will be 0 volt. To solve this, the output voltage comes to 4 volt. In exercise number 4, voltage is applied on both terminals. Such an operational amplifier is called subtractor operational amplifier. This time, first pay attention at the node point B. Due to input voltage V1 current will flow through node point B to the ground. In this case, if node analysis is done for node point B, then I1 will be equal to IZ. I1 will be V1 minus VB upon 20 kilo ohm and IZ will be VB minus 0 upon 20 kilo ohm. Solving this bring potential half volt at the node point B. Due to virtual ground, this potential will appear at the node point A. Now do node analysis for node point A, then I2 will be equal to I0. Value of I2 is V2 minus VA upon 150 kilo ohm and value of I0 is VA minus V0 upon 300 kilo ohm. Solving this brings the output voltage to minus 2.5 volt. Calculate the output voltage of this given operational amplifier. If comparing this operational amplifier to non-inverting operational amplifier, it has direct connected by removing feedback resistance, means RF is zero, and input resistance has been removed, which is RI is infinite. Since the input voltage is given at the non-inverting terminal, if we put these values in the output voltage of the non-inverting operational amplifier, the output voltage is equal to the input voltage. Such an operational amplifier is called a buffer circuit or voltage follower or unit follower because the voltage gain of this operational amplifier is 1 without any phase reversal. Exercise number 6 has a 3-stage operational amplifier whose output voltage we have to calculate. Along with this, voltage gain of all 3 operational amplifiers are also given. There are 2 methods to solve such operational amplifier. First, if the input voltage is applied to the first operational amplifier, then calculate its output voltage. The output voltage of the first operational amplifier will work as an input for second operational amplifier. Thereby calculating the output voltage of second operational amplifier, this output will act as an input for third operational amplifier. The second method is simple. The total voltage gain of any multi-stage operational amplifier connected in series is multiple of the voltage gain of individual operational amplifier. Since the voltage gain of all three operational amplifiers is given in the question, the voltage gain is in positive and negative numbers. Positive means that it is the voltage gain of a non-inverting operational amplifier, and negative means that it is the voltage gain of an inverting operational amplifier. So the total voltage gain of this 3-stage operational amplifier will be 48. Since the input voltage is 2 volt, the output voltage will be 96 volt. If the voltage gain in the question is not given, first of all calculate the voltage gain according to their inverting and non-inverting operational amplifier. This is a special type of operational amplifier called instrumentational operational amplifier. This circuit is its defined circuit diagram. The output voltage of this operational amplifier is proportional to the difference of the input voltage. This proportionality depends on its feedback resistance. When solving with node analysis, this is the output voltage of an instrumentational operational amplifier. Putting values in this formula brings the output voltage to minus 6 volt. The feedback resistance in this operational amplifier has been removed. In the absence of feedback resistance, it is called open loop operational amplifier. In any operational amplifier of inverting or non-inverting, if the feedback resistance is removed, the gain of the operational amplifier is infinite. An open loop operational amplifier also produces infinite voltage gain, meaning any voltage is applied to the input, only the infinite voltage will be produced in the output. The input voltage of a given operational amplifier is 2 volt. So will its output voltage will be infinite? No. Operational amplifier also has 2 terminals, VCC and VEE. These are installed so that the operational amplifier can work in a fixed region only. These 2 terminals never allow the output voltage to exceed their given values. Since the given operational amplifier has VCC and VEE plus 15 to minus 15, the output voltage will never go beyond this range, even if the voltage gain is infinite. So applying input of 2 volt should bring the output voltage infinite, but because of VCC and VEE, it give only plus 15 or minus 15 volt output. But plus 15 volt or minus 15 volt? It depends on which operational amplifier is used. Since the input voltage is plus 2 volt applied to the inverting terminal, the output voltage will be found with a phase reversal of 180 degree. So the output voltage of this operational amplifier will be minus 15 volt. This is also an open loop operational amplifier, but this time the input voltage is not in numeric value, but in the waveform of voltage. As we know in the last example, the output voltage of the open loop operational amplifier cannot exceed plus VCC and minus VEE. In this example, two things have to be taken care of. First, the input voltage is applied to which terminal, and the second, the phase of the input voltage is not constant. Its phase is reversed after half cycle. Speaking of the first half phase, the voltage is in positive phase and it is applied to the inverting terminal. Then the phase of the output voltage should change from 180 degree to minus infinite. But due to VEE, it goes down to minus 15 volt only. In the second half cycle, the phase of the input voltage is negative, and due to the inverting terminal, its phase becomes 180 degree change. Therefore, the output voltage must be finite in positive. But due to VCC, it becomes constant at 15 volt. So the output square wave of an input sine wave. Operational amplifier is also used in some mathematical operations, such as for differentiation or integration. It is a differentiator operational amplifier, in which input resistance has been replaced with a capacitor. The impedance of a capacitor is 1 upon G omega C. If denote G omega with S, it will be 1 upon SC. Similarly, the impedance of an inductor is G omega L, so it is written as SL. Now the problem is that the impedance of these two is in the form of omega frequency in the frequency domain. But for mathematical application, they have to change from frequency domain to time domain. Changing from frequency to time domain, the term S replaced by d over dt and the term 1 by S by integral dt. Now let's solve this question. I1 will be equal to I2 at the node point A. The value of I1 will be Vi minus Va upon 1 by SC, and the value of I2 will be Va minus V0 upon R. Va will be 0 due to virtual ground. Solving this brings the output voltage minus RSC Vi. This equation is in frequency domain. To change it to the time domain, replace S with d over dt. When doing so, the output voltage is minus RC d over dt Vi, which is the output voltage of a differentiator operational amplifier. If the input voltage is sine 1000t, the feedback resistance is 1 kilo ohm, and the capacitance is 1 microfarad, then solving it gives the output voltage minus cos 1000t, which is the differentiation of the input voltage. The negative sign has come because the input voltage is applied to the inverting terminal. In this operational amplifier circuit diagram, the capacitor and feedback resistance have been replaced by the comparison of differentiator. Such operational amplifier is called integrator operational amplifier. Again, at the node point A, current I1 will be equal to I2. The value of I1 is Vi minus Va upon R, and the value of I2 is Va minus V0 upon 1 by SC. On solving this, the output voltage is minus 1 upon RSC Vi. To shift the output voltage from frequency domain to the time domain, replace 1 by S with the integration. Then output voltage will be minus 1 upon RC integration Vi dt. Now if the input voltage is sine 1000t, then putting it in the equation brings the output voltage cos 1000t, which is the integration of sine. Mathematically, the integration of sine t is minus cos t, but due to applying the input to the inverting terminal, an additional negative term comes.